How's it floating, spacemates? Welcome aboard the Starship Infinix Flare. It's me, Infy, back again with Mass Effect Andromeda. Before we go off and find our father, I wanna access our menu and yep, I think we leveled up. So, yeah, here we are. I actually accessed this menu earlier on and it gave me some tutorial tips, but apparently they're gone now. So, it said that I leveled up and my squad members leveled up as well. So now we can take a look at assigning points to our skills, I guess. So, it seems like you can give your character any skills you want, assign skill points to any of the categories, no matter what class you chose right at the beginning, be it warrior, mage, or rogue. But if I'm not wrong, like energy drain, I started off with energy drain, so I already had rank 1 in it. It saved me 1 skill point, because it costs 1 skill point to, you know, learn a new skill. So I can immediately jump into like a rank 2. But if I wanted to, I could just put points into biotics as well, even though I didn't choose a biotic class right from the beginning. So I'm gonna look through all of this and then decide what I want to put points in, and then I'll jump right back. Okay, so I've spent 2 points. I bought Chiral Beam and Invasion because if I had a choice between ice moves and fire moves, I would choose an ice move. And then I chose Invasion because it sounded interesting. Infects opponents with an invasive VI controlled machine swarm that weakens defenses and spreads itself to nearby enemies. So that sounds damn interesting to me, which is why I bought it. As for Cora, I gave her Nova. So basically what I'm gonna do for squad members is I'm gonna activate their second, because they start off with 1 point in their first skill. I'm gonna give them the ability to use their second skill. So for Liam, I gave him his Havoc Strike, and then I left 1 point unspent for all my characters. So what happens is I'm gonna watch how they perform in battle. If they do well enough, I won't touch the offensive or the defensive parts of their passive abilities. So it seems like squad members have a offensive and a defensive passive ability each. So if they do pretty badly, like they die a lot, I will invest in their defensive abilities. But if not, I will just slowly develop triggerable abilities. I think that's the word for it. But that's it. Okay, so enough jibber jabber. Let's go find my dad. I have no idea where he is. Let me take a look at... Oh no, I'm standing in poison. Oh yeah. Before that, didn't I have like... Did I not get a... Oh, is it because I quit the game and it didn't save properly? Supposed to get... Didn't I get a shotgun around here? Okay, no matter. I thought I got it, but doesn't seem like it. So right now I only have the Predator pistol and the Avenger assault rifle. Which, yeah, let's turn back. Why are we turning back? Oh god. Lightning strike. Why are we turning back? Is this not the correct way? Oh, okay. I'm going the wrong direction. My bad, I thought it was this way. Yep, I'm sorry if this intro scene for this video, for this episode, hasn't been particularly exciting as of yet. But I am rushing towards the objective. This is the place, right? I think the place where he was is the part where... We don't have much time. Where the enemy came out in a patrol. The rot. The
we hug that wall, they might keep us safe.
Hug what wall? This wall? Yeah, didn't...
Lightning didn't do this!
Didn't...
This is more than we took out.
Incendiary rounds. My dad's been busy.
Yeah, they came out from this door. This gate.
Somebody was pretty clever with these rods. Only way to survive here.
Two, if you count shooting on sight.
This was where we were overlooking the base camp.
Weird. We were here earlier.
Yep.
Guess he's been pathfinding.
We were here earlier, that means we were the pathfinders. Oh hey, he's here. Hey dad, are you evil now?
Sir.
We're waiting for the big twist. Okay, I forgot what I wanted to choose first if I had all four choices available. If I remember correctly, I said I would pick casual before emotional. Casual is this one, and emotional is the top. So, emotional, logical, casual, professional. Yeah, I'm a casual person, so casual.
You never know what people are made of, not until everything goes wrong.
Plenty of that on this mission.
Sir, you said something about the lightning.
It's the dark energy cloud the Hyperion hit. It's affecting the whole planet. Interfering with that.
The tower is caught in a feedback loop with the cloud. Together they're disrupting the entire climate with undirected energy.
It would explain a cave we found. Plant life sheltered from the storm. From that tower.
It's a good bet. And I think if we can get in there and shut the tower down,
the lightning goes away.
And the shuttle can get us out of here, in theory. We just have to get past them.
It's a hell of a gamble, but we won't know until we get in there and try.
No illusions about this. It'll be a nasty fight the whole way.
If Sarah's game, so am I. But we risk turning a skirmish with these guys into something worse.
It's them or us.
Oh, it's them. The problem is we're outnumbered.
I've been working on that. We just need to change the math.
Oh, bombs. Big bada boom. You blew up the lightning rods. I think. Hot diggity dang. Oh, we're just jumping right in, aren't we? Alright, before we fight, 2 points I have to get off my chest before things go south. First thing is, I'm kinda disappointed that the aliens, the first aliens we met are humanoid, because I know it's easy to design aliens based on references to humans, but the fact that they're humanoid is, I don't know, it's just not that original. Plus they're like us, they're like humans except a bit rockier with blocks on their head. Second point is, Cora said my first name, she said Sarah. So what if I gave a different name to my character? Would she actually say that? Would it be like Fallout 4 where Codsworth had several names that he could actually pronounce? If so, that's kind of amazing. Okay, let's get into the fight.
Let's go!
Right behind you! Push ahead to the structure!
Sam, yo!
Load combat profile!
Here they come!
Infected!
Watch the lightning!
Maybe I should have infected him because, like, there was only one of him.
Get into that building. We don't want to get bogged down out here.
Oh, Cairo Beam is pretty cool as well. Guys, maybe just go inside. I think I'm getting shot at. Oh, hey. How's it floating? Oh, shit.
Go, 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 go.
Hey, you're frozen. And now you're broken. They're coming out of the woodwork. Where? In front here? Oh, upstairs. Oh, crap. Okay. Don't shoot at me, bitch. Oh! Breakable cover! Shit, my shoes are running low.
Sara, get moving.
I'm actually low on health too. Half health gone. Bam 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 bam. Oh god.
Biotic amp interface mode.
I'm here.
Keep the momentum up. Don't let him get the drop on you.
Ooh, health restored. Okay. Get in the cover. Get in the cover.
Have to keep an eye on our flank. Not if we keep moving forward. Don't let him catch us.
I'm gonna infect you. Oh shit! I fell down.
No idea, but it's working.
I think I died actually.
Let's get inside there.
Hoorah! Okay. Oh shit.
We're doing it. Not much farther.
Where are they?
All the way to the top.
I want to infect someone. Yeah.
We'll know when we get there.
Why is the audio is pretty soft actually. Ooh. Hey, how's it floating? Ooh, Cairo combo. Okay.
Almost fried me.
Sorry. Give me a moment because is it my headset? It might be my headset. Things were a bit soft for me. Cause look at this. It's all full. But I think it might be my Might be my headset. Oh.
Don't stop. If we fall.
Where are they?
Sam,
are they outside?
Give me engineer profile. Squad, on me.
Yeah, okay. Now my
Where are you getting these profiles?
It's a bit louder.
From Sam.
What does that mean?
Just focus on the fight.
Well, my friends seem to be charging a lot in the, like, the battle.
This looks like a control center. Keep him off my back.
You heard him.
We made it. In one piece. Not over yet. I need to get through that door over there.
Dude, the guy's like dead around here. Oh, God. Okay, dangerous. Bad, 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 bad. I'm charging too much. I got frozen. What the hell? Restore my health, please. Someone heat me up because
I need to decipher the language.
I was kind of frozen. Huh. Things are slightly hectic.
There's more coming up.
Coming up from
what? They'll surround us in no time.
We need to defend both sides or they'll flank us.
Where do you want us?
Order. Okay. I'll get you here and I'll get you here. Or do I get them here?
Got it.
Am I supposed to bring both of them here? Oh no. Okay, sorry, I didn't realize. One of you go there.
Watch it! Think I see movement.
We held them off at the shuttle. We can do it again.
Are they coming from these? Oh, they are. Ooh! Did a guy have a turret?
Hurry, we don't have long.
Yikes. Can I freeze that guy? Oh, he's got a shield. He's got a shield on it. Now let's go help the other side.
Well, 50% decrypted. It's an unusually complicated syntax.
I can see that. Try a recursive search.
I will need a moment to evaluate the pattern.
Hey, don't hide behind the cover.
Do it.
Yo!
I think I really pissed that one off.
Yeah, well, that guy's dead.
I shot him in the face.
Yeah. Oh no! Cora, why did you leave your post?
Sir, any progress?
Decryption is 75% complete.
We've almost got it.
Did I smash the guy? Oh no. Shit.
Just a little longer.
Ooh, doggy.
They're falling back.
Could be regrouping for another push. Stay sharp.
Come back here, come back here. Come back here, space mates.
Decryption complete.
That did it. It's a security override. I'll try to open the door from here. Ah, damn, it's jammed. I need to take a look at it.
I see people, but where? Like, I mean, I see them on the map,
sir,
but I don't
I
see them in real life.
No, it's okay. We'll keep a lookout.
We need to get this door open.
On it.
Oh, hey. Like I said, how's it floating?
We need to get this door open.
Oh, am I supposed to open the door?
That's an order.
I hate the controls because you can't really, like, tweak them. I don't know how to put it. What? I'm here. Dude. How did I fail the mission? I was, like, right there. Great. I need to redo this part again. This is fun. This is the second time I've actually failed or died. Whatever you want to consider it. The first time being the last episode where I actually died to a freaking bomb. Yeah, you bitch. Oh no, this guy's coming for me. Alright, that guy's dead. Yo, yo, stop. Oh, shit. Hey, doggy. Dude, I am trapped, kind of. Let me go get health.
We only have a moment. Do it.
Oh, you're fighting over here.
I think I really pissed that one off. Maybe because I shot him in the face.
I really want to do this. Booyaka! Okay. Finally got it. Oh, icebreaker. Okay. Got me a trophy too. The bad thing about the squad orders in this game is that you can't order them to use the powers that you want they have. I think they auto use abilities on their own, but you can't choose what skills you want them to use.
Put your back into it.
This thing down?
I don't know yet. Sam's decoded part of the language. Now we'll see if I can have a conversation.
Nothing on this planet has listened so far. Just be careful.
Worried about your old man, huh? I won't tell anyone.
Okay. Well, I guess
Come
my
on.
Father is
These are the moments
funny
to
at
make
times.
It all worthwhile.
He's not as hard a man as I thought he would be. Like, he can still
Sam, begin translating.
Still joke with us.
Indexing. Translation complete.
Let's see what we have.
So how soon before my father dies? Triforce! Am I playing Mass Effect or am I playing Zelda? Also, I thought there were enemies swarming us, but apparently they're gone.
I'll be damned. It's working.
Could this be our golden world?
There's hope at least.
That's all anyone back on the Ark is looking for. Hope it'll work out.
Well, not if we stand around looking at sunsets. Let's
He's gonna get shot.
Shuttle and...
Okay. Ooh! Okay, what just happened? Well, my helmet's cracked, but I'm not... I was just gonna say I'm not gasping for air, but the subtitles tell me otherwise.
Repeat! We need an emergency extraction now!
They're spinning up the shuttle. ETA is 3, maybe 4 minutes.
This is where my father is gonna die. Yeah, I bet you this is where he's gonna die.
Deep breath.
What are you...
Initiating transfer.
I knew my dad couldn't survive this. I mean, it wouldn't make sense because... If I had my Spectre father around me and around the game, then how do I put it? I wouldn't be able to be the main character.
She's going into cardiac arrest.
Like, I'll always have Ryder Senior over me. But this game is supposed to be about Ryder, so if Ryder Senior is still around and my father is still around, then yeah, I wouldn't be the main character of this story. The people would defer to his authority more than mine. They wouldn't listen to me.
It's a seizure. Her brain can't handle the connection. Get her to sound node. Sam, what's the reading?
Ryder's implant is overloading. I suggest a hardwire connection.
Do it.
There.
Also, it seems like I've been infected by something, which is kind of ironic considering how I've got the invasion skill that infects people.
Welcome back, Sara.
Or infects enemies.
What happened?
You were clinically dead for 22 seconds.
Did the rest of the team make it?
Hey, you're still with us. Guys, get to Sam Node. Ryder's awake. Who are you talking to?
Sam.
I didn't hear him.
You're up. Look here. And here.
My father. Where? It was your life or his.
I can't.
And he chose you.
Ryder's face is just funny.
I'm so sorry, Sara. I know this must be a blow.
This can't be happening. We weren't close. Were we not close? Was I not close to my dad? But I'm gonna be, this seems to be more of the emotional choice, even though it's not the actual emotional choice.
I can't believe he's gone. 1 minute, everything was fine, and then he...
I know he could be distant, but he once said that when his time came, he wanted to go out among stars no one had seen before.
What are we doing in Sam Node?
Sam is now part of you. In a way we don't entirely understand. It played havoc with your brain.
Sam?
Your father authorized the transfer of Pathfinder authority to you.
Shouldn't that be Cora?
In theory. In reality, you're the new Pathfinder, Sara.
No, are you kidding me?
You can't be serious.
What's the matter? I think you're up for it.
I haven't trained. That's easy to say. Only Cora agrees.
That's easy enough to say, but going out there and doing it? I barely survived that last mission. Hell, technically I didn't.
But you're alive and kicking now. You're not a quitter, that's for sure.
It's all academic anyway. Sam's linked to your mind on a deeper level now. Trying to untangle it could kill you.
I know this is tough, but we need to start thinking about the next step. A lot of people are counting on us.
Is the Ark still drifting?
That's the thing. Whatever your dad did with that tower, it saved the day. Some sort of atmosphere scrubber.
The energy cloud thinned out. We're on our way to the rally point now. Should be at the Nexus soon.
She needs to rest first.
She has 2 hours. We'll need our Pathfinder for this.
Oh, I checked on your brother. Still no change. But if you can pull through, so can he. A bit of your dad in both of you.
Your father will be missed.
What's going on, Sam?
This is our private channel. I shared it with him.
Why did he do it? Why me?
Unknown. But he never acted without reason.
Well, you are his daughter.
Alec wouldn't want us to lose sight of the goal. He said pain emboldens our resolve. He'd insist we grow stronger from his passing.
Yeah, well, to put it succinctly, what I said earlier on, if our father had been around, we wouldn't have been able to be the Pathfinder, because he was the Pathfinder. Now that it's gone, we are the new one, and we have a purpose. And are you the main bad guy? Your armor seems more regal. You have a halo around your head. You don't have enough fingers, dude. That's why it doesn't work. So now he's gonna come hunt for my father. But since my father is dead, they're gonna come for me.
See you on your feet. We're at the Nexus. It's the forward hub for the entire Andromeda Initiative. The Asari, Solarian, and Turian arcs should be there too.
So basically our citadel.
Let's hope they've had better luck.
Starting our approach now.
It's almost as big as the Citadel back home.
Nexus Control, this is Ark Hyperion, requesting docking clearance. Captain, I'm only getting their automated approach channel. Not a live person.
Well, like it or not, we're here. Take us in.
Oh no, it's been invaded by the GoSat aliens. Yeah, I'm calling them GoSat because that was the only thing I could make out from the conversations in the previous episode.
Could be worse.
How? Habitat 7's a bust. We might have started a war with the first aliens we met, and our Pathfinder's dead. This better be rock bottom. Green across the board. Docking initiated.
Hey, you know what? The ship looks like the drone thingy that the alien had earlier on.
I got us here. Good luck, Pathfinder.
I think Sarah's mouth is a tad too big for her face. That's why it's so funny. And if you can remember the weird smile she had when she woke up early on.
Captain,
yeah.
Just call me Pathfinder. This is really happening.
Just take a deep breath.
I still can't believe Dad's dead.
Deep breath.
This should have been his moment.
But now it's yours. You just need to decide what you're gonna do with it.
Where do I start? I'm just not sure I'm ready.
We weren't ready to fall out of the sky on Habitat 7. But we survived that.
I need engineering right to secure all connections.
So, always keep a jump jet handy.
What's the priority? Start running power and data links first.
Okay, since that they mentioned Korra, technically, theoretically, was supposed to be the next Pathfinder in case anything happened to our father, but now she's not. Will there be a jealousy arc? Well, if this was a Japanese anime, it would. There would be a jealousy arc where, like, Korra turns into our rival or something, and she's like, no, I should have been the one to get the power, but now I didn't, so I'm gonna be jealous of you and sabotage what you do, and then after that we'll have a redemption arc. I've been reading too much manga. Recently been catching up with one Hero Academia. What do you call it? I forgot. Finally we have something here, container open. Ooh, Viper! That's a sniper rifle. How do we... Inventory. See, I knew I had the katana shotgun. How do I equip it anyway? No, I do not want to deconstruct it. I forgot how you equip weapons in Mass Effect. Looks like I can't do any of this here. I don't know, resources, okay. Just taking a look through my menu stuff. But my characters, my teammates have gone on ahead.
Okay folks, this is what we've been waiting for.
Let's listen to them.
Teams know the docking procedures are now in effect. We've got 20,000 colonists still asleep. We'll need somewhere to put them when the alarm clock goes off. As soon as we get clearance from the Nexus, we'll be following stasis revival protocols. We want to avoid any log jams, so it's vital your teams coordinate with each other and keep people moving. Any questions so far?
How do we handle deaths that occurred in transit?
Right. It's an unfortunate fact that not everyone will have survived the voyage. We've already got scattered reports of medical problems from that dark energy cloud we hit. If somebody didn't make it, check with the medical officer. We'll see about notifying their next of kin. I'm hoping it's a rare exception. Also, try to keep it quiet. Andromeda is all about new beginnings, not holding funerals.
That's it? Okay. Well, I'm surprised that only the crew are awake and that the other 20,000 so-called people are still in cryostasis. So we were here early on in the game when it started going all shitstorm. And this is the tram. Okay, good. It would have been seriously lazy if the two people we saw earlier on were still here. So let's take the tram to where I don't even know where we're supposed to go. We are going into the Nexus.
Nice to see some friendly faces this time.
The Nexus runs a support crew, just enough to finish building the station and provide safe harbor for the Arcs.
It means we can start waking our people up.
They built a bar, right? Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
You're expecting one.
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
I was thinking more of whiskey.
Rough ride so far.
I like whiskey.
Real food and a shower are just ahead.
Whiskey with a cigar. Alright, seems like we're here. Hold options to track? Well, am I still tracking it? So confusing. Toggle tracked. Oh. So if I turn this off, okay. Right, I'm just testing out my buttons. As you could see, I turned that off and the marker disappeared. But now it should appear again. Yeah, hello.
I don't see any champagne.
I don't see anyone.
Where is everybody?
Decora just teleport right in front there. Immersion breaking.
Well, this can't be right. It's like everything's on standby.
If it's a surprise party, they're doing an awfully good job of it.
Surprise! Avena. Hey, Avena. I remember you. You're the AI back friend back in the Citadel.
Welcome to the Nexus, gateway to Andromeda. I'm Avena, a virtual intelligence designed to assist you with immigration.
Can you tell us where the welcome party is hiding?
I'm sorry. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations. Please select from the following pre-programmed responses.
Alright, let's start going through them one by one. Immigration.
How does the immigration process work?
We ask that you submit to a brief medical exam to ensure your health and well-being after making such a long journey. Once you've been cleared, our colonization experts will assist you in finding your new home. Please be mindful of the queue. Thousands of eager colonists like you are waiting to begin their new life in Andromeda.
Where? Place is deserted.
I'm sorry, my responses are limited because of my soulless eyes that stare at you as I talk. Alright, living arrangements.
Where do colonists live?
Once you've cleared
immigration, in my ass.
Our helpful staff will assist you in choosing the homeworld of your dreams. Will it be the tropical paradise of Habitat 7? The gentle rolling hills.
Tropical paradise of Habitat 7.
Perhaps the mysterious twilight world.
That was full of ionized storms.
Rest assured, our pathfinders have carefully vetted all colony worlds to ensure your security and prosperity.
Oh boy.
Habitat 7. That's where we landed. She's way out of date.
Yep. And I don't even know about Habitat 3 and 5. Andromeda Galaxy.
What can you tell me about the Andromeda Galaxy?
Here in Andromeda, you are over 2 million light years away from the Milky Way Galaxy. This is the furthest any life form has ever traveled outside our home system.
Boldly go where no one has gone before.
The Nexus itself is located in a region known as the Helios Cluster. Here, you and thousands of your fellow colonists will fulfill your dreams of settling a new home. Fortune awaits.
Fortune awaits! Glory to mankind! Sorry, wrong game. The Nexus.
What is the Nexus?
The Nexus serves as the central hub for the Andromeda Initiative's colonization efforts. It is the first destination for all colonists upon their arrival in the new galaxy. Please enjoy the many venues the Nexus has to offer. As the station expands, it will one day serve as the seat of government for Milky Way colonists. Providing a safe, stable, and prosperous environment is our primary goal.
Not from the looks of it.
Yeah, it looks pretty empty right now. It's like there's only the three of us. And the current year?
What year is it?
The current year is 2819. After spending over 600 years in stasis, it's normal to feel disoriented or confused upon arrival. Our helpful medical staff can assist with any physical or psychological after-effects you may be experiencing.
Well, she's got the date right, at least.
So where is everyone?
Logging off.
That's all.
It has been my pleasure. Please see one of our helpful immigration staff for further assistance.
Yeah, I can find one.
Welcome to your new home in Andromeda, where the brightest star is
you. Oh god, that's cheesy.
Immigration processing is unknown error.
Oh.
Right. That was
unknown
helpful.
Error. Okay. Let's take a look around.
Plants are still alive.
For how long?
It's like they didn't finish building it.
There's a guy. Maybe he's got champagne.
Dude, aren't you not weirded out that you're alone here?
Hi there. We're from Ark Hyperion, and wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you? Did you say an Ark?
Okay. Something weird is going on.
This is the Nexus, right? Pretty sure we parked in the right place.
And for what it's worth, your VI over there could use an update.
Of course, I'm sorry. It's just, we thought you were all dead.
What?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or... But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
I don't believe it. I'm Tyrion Kandros. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
I'm Sara Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an Ark had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
Well, I've got a shipload of people that says we're here.
Of course, it's just... you're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center.
No wonder things are so weird. Let's follow this friendly Turian.
Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
We're familiar with it.
Then you'll know why we called
it the
scourge.
Did the door just shut on me?
We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we called them.
Are things back to normal?
That's gotta be fun.
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
I highly doubt it. I guess we're supposed to use this. And I thought our friendly Turian would be the one pressing the button.
Any threats from the locals?
So far we've stayed hidden. We're in no shape to deal with an attack.
We had a first contact situation on Habitat 7. Whole thing went south. They tried to kill us.
That wasn't first contact. We know about them. Those aliens are going to be a real problem.
This day just keeps...
We're here.
Wait, what?
You guys go ahead. I'll check out the security situation.
We didn't even get, like...
fractured. Some
the whole...
for leaders who died.
Conversation.
Is it true?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an Ark to finally show up.
Docking procedures are green across the board.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
Oh, hey, a Salarian and a Krogan.
The crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
I'm Jaren Tan, director of the Initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
Not as much as it means to us. We had one hell of a time getting here. Nice to see some friendly faces.
Hungry faces. Any supplies you can spare would be appreciated.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at her.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Alec is dead. Please understand. The
God.
Entire initiative is at risk.
I'm sorry, I just can't stand
none of the Golden
the
Worlds
face.
Out. They're a bust, and there's been no word from the other arcs.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
Seems like we need to
find resources.
Yeah.
But that takes people, and we can't wake them up.
Until they have somewhere to live. A golden world.
Now
a
more
golden
than ever,
snitch.
We need a pathfinder.
We need to
Enough
catch the golden
you,
snitch.
Are you up to the task?
How is this emotional compared to logical?
Well, we came a long ways for nothing if I'm not.
We'll all die if you're not.
That's no way to treat a guest.
That's not how I would expect a Krogan to sound like.
I'm Nakmor Kesh, superintendent of this station. Hope they haven't scared you off already.
It's nothing personal.
The fuck?
Now isn't the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
That is a really...
We're all feeling the
different
pressure.
Tone.
Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss
of what a Krogan gives.
I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
You know, after Rex and Grunt.
Welcome to the Nexus.
From the previous Mass Effect games, they had deep grunty. They have deep sounding voices, but this guy is a whole new ball game. He's called Kesh.
Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here. What little we can find should have a chance.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is
now
online.
Yeah, I was just thinking
something.
That might be a female Krogan, and I guess she is.
An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
Which is why I guess a voice is like that.
Runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
I'm not sure if we were able to meet female Krogans in the previous Mass Effect games before. Oh, you receive an object. You've received an objective. Press options to view your journal. Seems like I can go talk to a lot of people. Speak with Tan, speak with Kesh, speak with Kendros, and speak with Allison. Alright. Where are they? On the map, do you tell me? Allison's office. So, seems like... Well, Tan seems to be the main mission. And the rest are not. Okay, cool. So let's talk to Addison first, I guess. Well, after eavesdropping on some of the characters around here. Juicy.
More power relays. Excellent. What? Girl Scout cookies. Hyperion's inventory lists Galactic Scout cookies.
Wait, really? Seriously? I want those.
You'll have to fight Kesh for the Galaxy Swirls.
I don't care. It'll be worth it.
Galaxy Swirls. I have no idea what's that. Oh, hey, aren't you... Wait, no, you look like a Turian. I think, because... She's green, so I thought she was the race that... Thane Krios was... The race that Thane belongs to. I forgot what the name is already. Because it's not something that we... It's not a race that we meet often. Thane's race.
Damn it.
Hello, Addison. You weren't very friendly just now. And you don't seem to want to talk to me.
Alright, what happened? To who? To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything.
Your face.
And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec. Not how he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
What's that mean? You know, I look at this. He wanted me to be Pathfinder. All that matters is he's gone. They seem to be switched. Like, this would sound more like an emotional response. And this like a logical response. So I don't get why it's like this.
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 40 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Alright, we got a lot of stuff to say. Colonial director position.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away. And here we are, idling.
Insights into strange tech?
There's also this strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Relationship with my father.
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends, or...?
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend.
Where is
he
our mom, anyway?
He didn't use his title. But no one's a Pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much like a colonial director without colonies.
The plan for the hostiles?
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad
Shit.
It is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't
Ket,
trust
huh?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder. Not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
Failing outposts.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
Okay. That was not a pretty picture that was painted. I guess I'll be going.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
Yeah, I have to pathfind something first, like she says, before she'll give me the time of her day. If not, she's just gonna give me shit. Ah, this door opens. Where does it lead us anyway? Oh, it's Cash's room. Hey, I think I like Cash for now. Also because she's supportive of me, like she's mentioned. Instead of like Addison, who's against us. Same shit, different day. For posterity, in case the initiative goes belly up. The Nexus is a four-ring circus. Don't like how Tan operates, and his disdain for the Krogan is obvious. I believe his intentions are ultimately good, but he's an opportunist who's likely to create dissent. I don't see the Nexus coming together if he's left unchecked. It's already polarizing Addison. She's taking the cue to circle the wagons. I think I can talk to Kandros about this, and at least try to get the two of us more coordinated. Or maybe not. Seriously hate this kind of drama. I guess this was written by Kiesh, because it's found here.
Unannounced caused some switches to blow. That's fine. I don't care. We know the problem is more widespread than we thought. We're working to fix it. That's all. My crew's working on it.
Okay, now that I know that she's female, the voice makes sense. Earlier on, when I thought she was a dude, it sounded really weird.
As soon as I have a moment, move on to the docks for now.
After, you know, our run-ins with Rex and yeah, other male Krogans in the previous Mass Effect games.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
Krogan whereabouts?
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to number 8 yet, have you?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the initiative.
Number 8.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over the Andromeda Initiative. I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
So what happened to number 1 to 7? Krogan deal with Tan.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
Why are you still here?
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
To spy on number 8. Okay, your job.
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place. I keep the station functional as possible, considering.
Nexus problems.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, was killed.
Oh, crap. Okay. I wonder how that person died. We saw the name on the datapad back in the Hyperion. One of the first... or was it the second datapad we read?
What happened to Gian Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders. Tan might know more.
And I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
Yeah, it's kind of like a vicious cycle. You need resources to support the people. But to find those resources, you need the people. But you can't wake them up. Because you don't have the resources to support them. Well, I guess that's what I'm here for, Miss Pathfinder. Oh, you're gonna ask about the genophage? Okay.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with the genophage.
Right. The genophage. A little gift to our people from the Solarians thousands of years ago. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
Wasn't a cure made in Mass Effect 3? I can't really remember.
No wonder your people have such a problem with Solarians.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Solarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Solarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about new beginnings. My people need that more than most.
Where did the Krogans go then? Are they still around the station? I don't think so. She said they walked out, so maybe they're inhabiting some planet or something.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show mutation against the virus. A natural defense. During the trip to get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. It's still early, but I think we made a dent. Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we had. Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
Okay. Can you bump uglies now? Because I don't remember. I don't think we were able to have romance with Krogans before in the previous games. I'm done for now.
Nothing more for
Bye.
Now.
Bye.
See you later.
You are interesting. Oh, Nakmore Kesh. Okay. So let's go find, what's his name, Kandros? Before we go talk to Director Tan. Where is Kandros? I think he's around here. Okay. Right, just want to explain something before I carry on. So I went to look up, because I remembered that when you picked your training at the start of the game for each character, there were 6, right? And I picked Leader. And I remember that I started out with Energy Drain, and then there were 2 other skills. I didn't know what that was about. So, here I am highlighting Annihilation, because that's one of the skills that was mentioned for the Leader training. So what happens is, essentially, if you picked Leader like me, Annihilation is immediately unlocked for your character. If you didn't, it would be like a charge here where it says 9 skill points invested in biotics as a requirement. So if you didn't pick Leader, Annihilation wouldn't be unlocked. You would need 9 skill points invested in biotic skills before you can actually pick it. So the other skill was team support, if I'm not wrong. So yeah. I'm not sure if I want to spend my remaining 1 point in Annihilation. Because I don't know if we can actually respec in-game, and I don't know what's our max level and how many skill points do we get in the end. What I do know is apparently we will have different loadouts available later on. So you can actually quick swap between loadouts, so you can put different skills into the loadouts. Yeah, but I don't think it's unlocked right now. Maybe a bit more when I progress a bit more into the game. So where I left off was I wanted to go talk to Kandros, and he's right here. Hello.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Arc.
What's the word on the Turian Arc?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Coming to Andromeda.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know? Then my sister became a sculptor and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that I stayed in service. But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
And now you are. I don't know if it's a case of be careful what you wish for. Okay, the Ket.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Your role?
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to war on the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny. Once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Turian welfare.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
Militias uses.
It's rough out there. I might need backup if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
Huh. Okay, that sounds cool.
Bye,
like
Kandos.
You have a team.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
At your beck and call. So, Tyrion Kandros. Where is the strike team supposed to be anyway? Oh, strike team missions.
This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrion Kandros for authorization to participate.
But I already did.
What am I going to do?
That's the console for our strike teams.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex, combat experts who've signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
I'll deploy your people carefully, Kandros.
Appreciate that, Ryder. But trust me, Apex can handle themselves. Authorization complete. Good luck out there.
There was that dude in the background crouching around. So weird. Online features cannot be accessed until you connect online. Please return to the main menu to connect before trying. Oh, so it's a online thing? Okay. I do have a secondary... Seems like a secondary objective though, which is speak with the distraught Turian. Guess it's this one. Mariette. Okay, before that, I'll examine this. Says Apex status, Lieutenant. Based on status report 16C, it seems we're no closer to gaining a foothold in any sector. Without decent recon and greater intel on this enemy, I'm starting to think our efforts are futile. The risks involved and continued losses, loss of resources and lives, makes it hard to justify. With morale this low, we need to scale down expectations again. Kandros. Who is the lieutenant? Let's skip this person first. Operations. Oh, hey. Liam, are you flirting with this? Is that Nicki Minaj?
Just wrong.
It looks like Nicki Minaj.
Pathfinder. No time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is it. Let's call it strained.
I can believe it. Nexus is running on empty.
Not just that. A lot of the exiles were security. Everyone was trained and armed for Frontier. We know Kett are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
They were frustrated. If they just wanted to kill, they could have fought to the last here.
Apparently, we're the big hope for everyone. Not the Hyperion showing. Just us. I'm with you. It's just... a lot.
This wasn't in the job description. We have to find a world, then save it.
Glad it's not just me feeling it. But it's not just you either. We're a team, right? It's what they need us to be.
So weird, like, we had this lady standing right next to us, but she didn't talk at all. So, awkward.
Nobody's making Creeper in Andromeda.
Oh, she's caught. Oh, no. There was a professor somewhere talking, according to the subtitles. Would it be the ones around here? Oh, there you go. Professor Herrick.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Herrick. Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
I'm usually out in the field, but I wouldn't mind talking shop, or lab, you know.
You are always welcome.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Okay, I no comment on that.
Pathfinder, those bioscans are superb. Could you gather more for our comparative conservation effort?
What conservation effort?
Ah, my thesis is on the console there. Broad strokes, we're comparing and preserving organisms from both galaxies. If you donate more bioscans and samples to the catalog, I can get you a finder's fee. Tempted?
Yes, more money is always good. I guess this is the stuff where I scan things. And yeah, I get my reward or something. Actually, could I scan things inside here? Oh well.
Pathfinder, we've had some trouble.
Aridana. Dr. Aridana.
I discharged an away team to get readings from a section of the Scourge that was behaving anomalously. They haven't reported in for some time, and sensors can't locate their shuttle.
Well, they're probably dead.
Good, dedicated people. I fear what might have happened to them.
Don't give up hope. When I'm out there, I'll see if I can find them.
Their friends and family will want to know what's happened. And I need to know.
It's okay, good doctor. Everything will be just fine. Now, where is the console? There you go. Final proposal, Professor N. Herrick et al. I don't know what N stands for. Since we are, by definition, an invasive species in Andromeda, our inevitable footprints must be laid carefully, and we must preserve anything we replace. The Helios cluster presents an unexpected challenge. We arrived with seed archives and DNA banks to ensure preservation of the biodiversity of the Milky Way. But this cluster is scarred by the Scourge, and its unique flora and fauna are threatened by its turbulence. That too requires conservation. Okay, I've activated it. I can't talk to Herrick anymore. Let's check our journal. No, this is not it. This one? No. It should be under here. Scan Andromeda Wildlife. Alright, I need to scan 10. I'll get back to this. Alright, let me through! See if anyone's around here. Oh, that's security footage. I wonder why. Container, open. Sesame, I will take all. Thank you very much. What's this? Omnigel canisters are often found on defeated Milky Way exiles or acquired by dismantling exile weapons and armors. They can be purchased from certain merchants. I don't know what all this is, by the way. Supposedly blueprints, but how do I use them? Okay, nothing here. I will check this security footage. For what? I have no idea. Oh. It's a bunch of mail. Which I am... Do I read it out to you guys?
Please report to the Hyperion coupling annex.
If I read out every single thing I come across, this let's play is gonna take a 2000 hours. I think this is a buying, yeah. Hey, merchant. Arms merchant.
Weapons and stuff. I got you covered. Use the console to take a look through what I got. It'd be a lot easier if I weren't missing half my stock.
Oh no, are you gonna like ask me to recover your stock?
You got it. Shop till you drop. Here I come.
That's fine. Hey, wait. Please don't drop anything you bought from me, okay?
It's just a phrase. You on my account. Jeez. Okay. Here we go. Vendor items. So we have these. This is an ultra rare shotgun. Okay. Sell all salvage as square. Show details as triangle. Right, okay. Just needed to press left and left to reach this part. I think it would be okay if I just press square to sell all the salvage. That nets me 1920, whatever currency you call that. And press start, trade, yes, let's sell all of them. Okay, so. How do I use these mods? Apparently not here. I can actually buy this. Can I? No, I can't. Cost 3,600, only have 2,000. That's not what I wanted to do.
Hey.
But I think that is it. I mean, unless I want to buy one of these, like this Falcon or the Omniblade 2. Is there any way to tell that I already have this item? No way, huh? Unless I remember that I have them. I don't need new stuff right now. Already sold all my junk. Now let's go talk to that distraught Turian who was muttering.
What am I going to do?
Hello. Press triangle to talk, not X.
Right. It's not fair.
What's wrong?
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
Exile, huh? Guess it wasn't for having a hand in the cookie jar.
They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial.
Ooh, here comes the crime for us to solve.
At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Okay. I wouldn't mind. I just need to know where is he.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Okay. And Liam was ogling at us from the in the background. How do we even do that? Helios assignments? First murderer, speak with the prison guard. Okay. Let's do that. Oh, hey, it's right over there. Oh, that must be Nilius. Hey, bro, Surgeon Acker. Acorn, I don't know.
You?
Pathfinder Ryder, here to see Nilkin Rensis.
Ah, our murderer. Wife's here all the time. Guess she told you her sob story. Nilkin, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanted to chat with you.
The Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
Your wife's all broken up over this. She says you didn't do it, and that she loves you.
She's a wonderful person. At this point, it's too late. They found me guilty.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend,
Ryan Reynolds.
He refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
Last I checked, getting into a spat wasn't against the law.
There's more. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and I guess I panicked and fired. Witness saw the chief's chest explode.
Ooh, a chest buster in Aliens.
I'm so sorry. That's
so there's
awful.
A new Alien movie coming out.
Close.
I really, really want to watch it.
I admire that about him. But I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
Don't throw in the towel yet. I'll review the evidence. Maybe I can find something that'll help.
That would be great. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Maybe it's Maybelline. Alright. You're making us run back and forth to talk to people.
No news on the Turian Arc yet. Or is this militia business?
I spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
Doesn't seem right to put all that on him.
Of course it isn't, but that's the perception. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
That's not a very good defense.
And you assume he's lying.
What's a lie to a murderer? Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you queue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
Too early to jump to conclusions, man. I mean, I don't know. Maybe we'll get to make a decision.
Evidence 7A.
Hiram! Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back.
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to... No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Okay. Sounds like he grabbed hold of Reynolds. You know, they got into a scuffle. Kerfuffle. The person is upstairs, I think. The marker points up. I'm gonna assume so. Ah, there you are. Cassidy Shaw.
Cassidy Shaw? I'm Sara Ryder. I'm looking into the Nilkin murder case.
Oh man,
you have nice curly hair.
Have you heard the audio recording of their fight?
It looks like toothpaste.
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the chief. He looked right at Nilkin and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Ooh, what a cat there.
Did you see any cat in the vicinity?
Nilkin said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
Well, I guess it was a good opportunity to kill off Reynolds. Did you agree with the chief?
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer.
Stop being so PC. Oh, God.
Ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
Good, good. Let out your opinions. Don't say you didn't decide, like... Did Nilkin regret it?
Did Nilkin seem remorseful?
I last sight of Nilkin in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated. Could have been guilt. The reality of the act sinking in?
No, I don't know. Why was the chief shocked?
If they'd fought and Nilkin threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Fronts fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part. The chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
Oh no, don't do that to me. Thank you.
I appreciate the information.
Miss Shaw.
Of course. It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Tian wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
Okay, so we gotta speak to Tan about it. And we gotta speak to Tan about the Nexus anyway. Let's see. Right, I don't have anything else that is... I mean, any other missions that occur on this Nexus. So let's go to Director 10.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules hers.
Does she know that?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the golden worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Ooh, sick burn.
Where's my ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Was I supposed to be holding
Ryder,
my face because
Hyperion,
my hand wasn't touching it?
We need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
All right, I've leveled up. I can continue talking to him, but let's take a look around his office, which is just more construction stuff. Hey, Director Tan. Talk to him.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
They're as much a part of the initiative as the human arc. We'll find them.
We have to. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Yes, about the Nilkin murder charge.
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to Eos and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
I'm hoping it proves something else happened.
This case has been a political nightmare. With all we've been through, the people need stability. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it. We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene. Good luck.
Oh, okay, I can actually have some conversation with him. Nexus troubles.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
Gian Garson's death.
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
That's unfortunate. Scourge disaster.
Kandros mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we call them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Sloane Kelly?
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them.
What a twist.
Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen. Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
Where are the Krogan?
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
They left where? That's the thing I'm curious about.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
And that was just one point. Right, missing arcs.
Any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
Yeah, you just have a lot of humans running around. Additional arcs.
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
Well, it could introduce, you know, new alien species or races. I know you've already done the cat, but I would like more new ones that are friendly. The Andromeda Initiative.
What more can you tell me about the Initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Initiative Origins.
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the Initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Motivations for coming.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons, one for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them, the thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
Alien species on Nexus.
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several Initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix.
As a and Solarian, we will rule the entire galaxy.
Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
I've already selected that. More. Tan's role.
As director of the Initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me. They don't see me as the rightful successor.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles, some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Right, no wonder he was called number 8. By Addison. But seriously, he's number 8 in succession and he was just a deputy assistant for revenue management. So he was an assistant treasurer. Something like that.
So you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you.
Yeah.
We are all capable of more than we know.
What?
When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the Initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Last one. Planet viability.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on site can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
What's with the sudden tone change? Hey, that's about it with Tan.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course. As you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
I think he's okay. I think he's not a bad guy made out as bad as is made out by Addison and... What the hell? Okay. by Addison and Cash. Raj Patil, what did you do, you naughty boy?
I'm fine. My arms got the brunt of it.
Did they burn off?
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
Where are the exiles anyway?
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
You know what they say. It's not paranoia.
If someone is out to get you, yeah. Third time this week. It's getting worse. First one was small stuff. This one could have hurt bad if I'd been closer.
That's not good. Sorry. Understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Whoever's doing this has to be stopped before someone gets seriously hurt.
That's what I'm trying to do. But I'm an engineer, not a PI. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait, that's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me, if they start hitting critical systems.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni-tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Alright, looks like we got some of this shit to do before we head to EOS.
Find out why.
Let's see. No, not this. Station sabotage. Investigate operation center site. Investigate militia site and investigate Pathfinder HQ. Why was there like a vibration? Oh yeah, where does this lead to? Leads to the tram. Oh, hey, Cora, you're here.
Disembarkation procedures for Hyperion are on hold. Please await further instructions.
I guess you use the tram to go to other places. Let's talk to Cora first.
Hey there. You okay? Those guys really grilled you. And Addison. First Pathfinder they've seen in over a year. All she can do is question your competence?
Which one was Addison again? All politicians look the same to me.
Same here. Next time we'll ask for a seating chart. I worked out logistics with Director Tan. They're giving us a ship and crew. He said their best is taking care of it.
I still need to head back to the Ark and check in with Sam.
Sounds good. While you're there, maybe see how your brother's doing.
I hope he's been revived by now. Seriously. Will he get to be part of my team, or will he be separate? What is that?
Please report to the Hyperion coupling annex.
I don't know, yeah, this thing is... Is it above me? So it's like in a, it's in a radius around here. Must be this one.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel.
Okay. How do I do that? Oh, hey. But what about the other places? Like this one. Right, wait. Aren't we in the militia office?
Beware of any suspicious activity. Security is on heightened alert.
Scan and trace the wiring to locate the panel that the saboteur used.
Do they all lead to the same spot?
Disembarkation
Let's go to the third one first and scan it. But I have a feeling they all just go to the same place. Sam doesn't even bother to speak this time. I don't see the pipe. Okay. This one doesn't seem to have a pipe. Alright, this one leads all the way up there. The one that led to Kesha's office seemed to break off.
All personnel, be aware of any suspicious activity.
Oh, hey.
Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
It'll be in the security update, somewhere in your message queue.
Looks like I have to investigate the last one. Oh, here it is.
Pathfinder, I received the data from Sam. It really is sabotage.
Any ideas to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion main deck.
Hyperion main deck? How do we even go there? Looks like we have to take the tram. Okay, let me take a look at our main one. Okay, we have to go to the Hyperion and speak to Sam in Sam node. So, it's on the way. Let's go confront this Zara before we head off. Seems like there's only one option, like there wasn't anything else to choose. The moment I used the tram thingy, it brought me back to Hyperion. Alright, let's find this Zara. Whoa, what the hell is that guy doing? Haha! Looked like he was breakdancing. Are you Zara? Where are you?
Where is she?
Let's check the map. Alright, just a bit more.
Where is the trigger?
That's dangerous if she's on our ship.
What's the latest about waking people up?
Alright. Hey, you. You mofo.
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here, I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing. And it led
oh
us
no,
to
Raj is the
My
bad
scans
guy.
Point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
Ooh, okay. It would be funny if it had been Raj.
Looks like someone is using both you and Raj to cover their tracks.
They'd need pretty high level access for that. Still, it's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both. Just keep a low profile and don't talk to anyone. I'm on it.
Okay, so where is the... No. Wait. God, do I have to go back to... I have to get back onto the tram, right? And then go back to Nexus. Ah, god damn. Huh, I can go to the Cairo Bay. Or I can... Oh, okay, so I actually had a bit of options when I used the tram station. No one's in here with me, okay. Let's go back to operations. I'm hearing footsteps. Which is probably a glitch.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power from the Hyperion.
Hello. Security footage. Right. Network access instability detected. Timestamp scrambled. Playback corrupted.
This file is useless. Let's check another.
I've seen all these before. So, yeah, I guess this one is related to the mission. Network access instability regurgitated. Timestamp scrambled. Playback corrupted. Failsafe disabled. System restore required.
And another scrambled file.
Coincidence seems unlikely.
Let's check another.
Maybe Raj and Zara are working together and they're both evil.
This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Somebody working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled, but if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
Okay. What? We need to scan them individually. Do we like scan them like that? Is it that guy hiding there? You mother f-
inaccurate match.
Okay.
All personnel, be aware of any suspicious activity. Security is on heightened alert.
Human male, right?
Inaccurate match.
And the last one would be where? I have to go back to the Nexus. I mean the Hyperion. Okay. This is turning out to be a bigger thing than I thought it would be. And also more tedious. Right, so we could go to the habitation deck or the cryo bay. I keep saying it wrong. The ops center is on Nexus, right? But the other two is on Hyperion. Okay. Yeah. Once I finish this quest, I am gonna end the episode. Cause I'm pretty sure it's a real long video. But since I'm releasing this weekly, that should be fine. Oh no. Please, is this you?
Biometrics do not match.
Okay. I'm kind of apprehensive as to how the confrontation will turn out. You there. I'm zeroing in on you.
Scan results show a partial positive. Target is most likely suspect.
Hey, I know.
Who is he?
Shows me your name.
Reports to Kandros' department, assigned to station security.
And he's in the middle of sabotaging another panel.
Dale
you
Atkins,
stop right there.
We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
Is that what sabotage is called these days? Work?
You're pretty arrogant for the new kid. You don't even know what's been going on.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Figures.
Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station. You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
Out where? I'm very curious as to where all the mutiny people... There's a word for it. I forgot. Mutineers? Where are they? They've been exiled, right? But exiled into what? Outside the Nexus? On the planet or something?
I'm sorry for what happened, but setting explosives isn't the answer.
Neither was sending people into exile because they didn't agree with policy. I don't care what you think.
Shoot him dead.
Mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people. Killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
We can't let you stay on board. There's no saying what else you're capable of.
Wait, you'd let me go?
If you call exile letting you go, sure. You leave and you don't come back.
I'll leave.
Oh, I'll leave. All right. That's done and dusted. What is that, a robotic vacuum cleaner? We actually have that in real life. Haha. Did you just come in next to me? Okay. My character actually has a pretty big rack. Because I'm looking down right now and it's popping out. Whatever. Anyway, I think that's about it for this episode. If you've enjoyed the video, why not leave a like and a comment down below? And if you want to find out what happens next, be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you can stay updated with the series. As always, I'll see you guys in the next one, and this is Infy, blasting off into space in the Hyperion.